Ano muna ako?
Birds
lip tint.
Lip gloss.
Lip tint yan eh, no?
Cable moment. Deadpool.
Okay.
Hindi ka nagdadry eh.
Kulang sa halik. Okay, so marami nagtatanong sa'yo.
How to open a UITF account?
How to invest in a unit investment trust fund?
Yeah.
Okay, so paano nga ba?
Well, basically, pumunta sila ng banko.
Okay.
UITF kasi is basically offered by banks. Eh. So
they are mostly offered in banks. Kasi I know some investment companies na may UITF din.
Manulife. For one,
may UITF.
And bago lang approve life, naka-seek na sila ng approval from the BSP to form a trust, ano?
Investment.
Entity. Oo. So baka magkaroon na ni CPF. So anyways, they can just go basically to the bank or like that, Manulife na nag-offer ng UITF. And yeah, they can look for the branch manager or the investment counselor there.
Mm-hmm.
Tapos, kadalasan kasi pag UITF, no, is dapat may account ka na dun sa banko.
Sa banko. So, kasi ang isa sa mga barriers sa pag-i-invest ay hindi alam kung saan pupunta at saka paano. And I usually recommend UITF as especially for beginner investors because all they have to do is to go to their own bank. So, almost all commercial banks offer UITF investments.
Mm-hmm.
And yun nga, pupunta lang sila sa banko.
Tapos,
kung saan sila may account para hindi na nila kailangan mag-open ng bank account dun sa ibang branch.
Tapos mag-over the counter pa. Kasi usually yan sa UITF, inaano na lang eh, kinukuha na lang
sa debit na lang dun sa savings account nila.
Oo. Tapos, may invest na. Of course, may cut-off time din yan.
Mm-hmm. Pero kasi, di ba, pag mag-open ka ng UITF investment, hindi ka naman basa-basa mag-open, no? Usually, the bank staff or will have you
May pinapa-fill out pa sa'yo na iba-iba yung tawag eh. But usually, it's client suitability questionnaire or investment suitability questionnaire. Basta,
Risk assessment.
Basta malalaman mo doon kung ikaw ay tipong conservative, moderately aggressive, or aggressive investor.
So, dyan na rin nilang masasagot kung anong UITF ba sila mag-invest. Kasi maraming iba't ibang UITF
kasi
investments.
Kasi usual tanong din yan na anong UITF po ba okay sa ano ko mag-invest? So that particular questionnaire, mafi-filter out niya na kung ano yung, kumbaga of the so many UITFs na ino-offer nila, ano yung pinaka
suitable
the best
sa kanila.
Pinaka-suitable for your given goal.
The best investment is hindi yung investment na pinakamalaki yung kinikita. But
not
the best investment is yung suitable sa iyo.
Parang damit lang.
Oo, tama.
Yung pinaka-fit sa iyo.
Oo, so and the bank will definitely be able to help them know ano yung UITF na meron sila.
Saka ano ba yung mga UITF? Like, for example, conservative lumabas. So lumabas on money market or bond fund. They would also be able to explain to you kung ano ba tong money market.
Ano yung difference nila?
Saan ba to ini-invest? Ganyan. Ano pa rin yung holding period na tinatawag.
Oo. So ano yung mga kailangan nilang tanungin? Yung minimum investment
to invest, kung
holding period,
tas minimum to add,
minimum to top up.
Yeah. Minimum to top up. Usually ang UITF ngayon, they can have as low as 50 pesos, 1,000 pesos.
May mga ganyan na, di ba?
May mga ganun to add 500 pesos. So talagang kayang-kaya.
Yeah, and also some banks nag-o-offer na rin ng auto investment, no?
Oo.
Every month kakaltasan ka ng 1,000 doon sa savings account mo, ililipat nila doon sa investment account mo.
So ano na 'yan, kumbaga
automatic investment, no? So hindi na nila iisipin.
Oo, tama. Yeah. Tapos syempre after noon, syempre pipirma-pirma ka ng maraming form, and then they should also look for the maganda rin, no, if they should also look for the fact sheet.
Oo. Para alam nila kung ano yung kung saan ini-invest yung pera nila.
Kasi that fact sheet will tell you kung ano yung historical performance ng fund.
Mm-hmm.
Tapos may graph din dun eh. Nakalagay din dun na since nag-umpisa yung fund, ito yung performance
ito yung kinita niya.
Tapos makikita mo kung more or less ano yung performance niya over the years.
Okay. So,
portfolio allocation nandun dun din. Kung saan ini-invest, kung ilang percent sa equities. Nakalagay din dun yung top 10 holdings. For example, yung top 10 companies na pinag-i-invest nila or the top 10 bonds.
Okay, so to summarize, they can go to their own bank where they already have a savings account.
Para mas madali.
Para mas ma-convenient
yes.
And mas mabilis. And ask the bank manager or the investment specialist to assist them in opening an account. Expect them, expect na mag fi-fill out sila nung
siguro mga
questionnaire.
15 minutes tapos na.
Nakapag-open ka na.
Oh, tanong niyo rin yung holding period pala, no? Kasi the holding period would say na gaano, kumbaga, gaano kakatagal na dapat nasa fund nang wala kang penalty pag nag-withdraw ka.
Oo. Pero usually 30 days lang naman 'yan eh.
Pero alam mo, may isa akong alam na ano na institution ngayon, financial institution, wala silang holding
period. Holding period.
So kung nag-invest ka today, bukas pwede ka na agad mag-withdraw.
Oo. At saka usually pag withdraw mo 'yan, 2 to 3 banking days ba? Or the next day?
Depende. Kapag
kung anong oras, no?
well, pag stock market, pag may stock market yung investment, usually after 3 days, makikredit sa
yun na yung pinakamatagal.
Matagal na yun. Pero pag global funds, for example, kunwari naka-invest in offshore funds, minsan mga 5 days and 7 days. Eh. Pero kapag naka-invest lang naman sa mga bonds or money market,
local
yan, usually after 1 day makikredit na sa account mo yan. Tapos look also for the ano, for the cut-off time.
Cut-off time.
Oh, kasi for example, pag sinabi nilang cut-off time is 12, so yung pag nag-transa ka before 12, yung makukuha mong net asset value per unit o NAV po, okay, we also have a video on that one on UITF. Makukuha mo yung price for that day pag before cut-off time. Pero pag after cut-off time ka na nag-invest, ibig sabihin yung transaction mo would be considered next day's transaction na. So be mindful of that one also.
Yeah. Alright. So I hope natulungan namin kayo and nabigyan kayo ng linaw kung paano ba mag-open ng UITF. Linaw. Malalim ako mag-Tagalog ngayon. Anyway, so kung nagustuhan nyo ang aming episode for today.
Tagalog agad.
So, bigyan nyo ng thumbs up.
Tunay.
Ayan. Give it a like and share it to your friends. And please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Yep.
So, bye-bye. See you next week.